Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. It's still early in the season, but a lot can be learned from early matchups in conference play. Time to take you out to the Pac-12. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football pregame show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Of Tempe Town Lake. Sun Devil Stadium is the site for another great game of college football. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. Thomas from the four. They'll bring him down at the 27. Golden Bears have a new head man. New theories, new hopes, new dreams. Will there be new wins? We'll find out. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Tackle made at the 38.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
Get to that quickly. He's taken down at the 46.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
And he's tackled at the 47-yard line.
Gain of 7 on the play. First down.
He gets to about the 27-yard line.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
And he's going to be sacked.
I think this defensive end is doing a great job of getting after the quarterback, not only with the sack in this case, but it seems like the entire game he's done a good job of creating pressure, making this quarterback feel him, and almost giving him happy feet back there. He doesn't seem to be in rhythm and almost seems to be throwing the football, feeling the pressure and almost creating the nerves on the quarterback.
From the 35-yard line, it's second down. On the delay, and he's brought down immediately. Darts it to the right. That close to being intercepted.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
Allen is waiting for the snap. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. The Sun Devil's offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I've really recognized is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Gets out to about the 31. And they keep it on the ground for the first down.
Nothing too fancy here. The key is that the running back was able to convert the first down.
He's on the run. Now he's going to run and watch out. And he is drilled at the 38-yard line. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Quick shot to the tight end, and he can't pull it in.
Williams was the intended receiver on the play.
Quick throw, and he's taken down around the 36-yard line, and they lose a couple there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
Estes, back to return it. Oh, what a hit. Well covered by the kicking team. He didn't go anywhere.
What I like about this play is that the guys stayed in their lanes and didn't allow the big play.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
They'll work the left. Just throws this one away. Fleming, the return man. Tackle at the 37-yard line. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Fires it out, and down he goes, right around the 50.
If you're the defense, who do you try to cover this guy with? He's too fast for most linebackers. He's too big for most corners. You have to rely on your safeties, who generally aren't very good in one-on-one coverage.
Strike to the receiver. They'll bring him down at the 40-yard line.
That's good for the game of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
From the 40-yard line, second down. Tackle around the 38-yard line.
Was the intended receiver on
So at the end of one, this one's scoreless. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we've got a tight ball game. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen.
Knocked out of bounds at the 30-yard line.
From the 30-yard line, third down. Run up the middle. Zips it out, and it's the tight end again. Brought down around the 12-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. Reese gets the call again, and they make the stop at the 14-yard line.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
So it's second and 12. Ball on the 14. They'll get him for a loss. 1 yard loss for the halfback.
How about the hit by the defender? Just a great job of pursuing the ball, and that's how you finish off a tackle.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Complete one of his receivers. They'll line it up for the field goal. Arizona State is looking to go up by 3. Kicks up, and the field goal is good. Hills is lined up to kick this one off. Estes takes from the 10, and he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Makes it to the 44. Fires complete over the middle. He's tackled right around the 48-yard line. First down. Quick strike, and he drops it. Martin intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10. From their own 48-yard line, second down. They'll knock him down for a loss. Spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Tackle made at the 40.
Wow, that looks like a generous spot to me. I thought he was a little bit short.
And they're going to put 6 DBs on the field to counter that 5 receiver look. There's a strike complete, and he's immediately tackled. He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
He fights forward to about the 33. Here they come. He's wrapped up for the sack. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Slings it, and he's leveled at the 27-yard line.
I'm not sure if the back was his first option, but he got in the ball, and he was able to make something big happen.
From the 27-yard line, first down. And he throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Steps up in the pocket, throws it to the outside.
Well, these guys lost a lot of talent to graduation last year. They've got to put some new faces in there. And this guy looks like he's the real thing, and he can help in that area.
This is the 12th play of this drive. Short over the middle. Has some daylight. Inside the 10. Brought down near the goal line.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
First and goal from the 3. Let's see if they can muscle this one in. Strike tight end, and that's a touchdown. So he was able to connect with a tight end for the score.
Yeah, they did a nice job inside the red zone of mixing up the play calling. That touchdown obviously fooled the defense.
And he converts the extra point. So a 13-play, 66-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. So the score now, 7-3. California ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 1. And he's tackled at the 20-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He's out of bounds, right around the 24-yard line. From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. Gains his way to the 39-yard line.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
He's scrambling, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And he hits him hard at the 44.
It's always a snap decision when you decide to tuck it and run. On that play, it was definitely the right move as he got the first down after a nice game.
from the 44-yard line. First down. He's taken down at the 35. Arizona State's called their final timeout. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw into the end zone here. He launches one for the end zone. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. This one's going deep to the end zone. Doesn't get there. A great first half comes to a close. California's up by four. Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 29-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Second and eight. Ball on the 31. He makes it to the 32-yard line. That'll bring up third and eight. Throws quick to the receiver. Falls incomplete.
Reese is intending to see on the play. That makes it fourth and eight.
Hills is the punter. He's tackled at the 39-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. California holds a four-point lead. Gets to about the 41-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Penalty markers down. They took too much time.
Delay of game. Offense.
They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
It's third down and 11 to go. Ball on the 38. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds.
First and 10.
Ready? Check back.
And he's taken down at the 36. California is up by four. And he's tackled right away. And a quick throw. So he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Third and 12 coming up on this one. Ball on the 39-yard line. Over the middle to his tailback. There's a very impressive open field tackle. The screen is good for four. To the end zone. He'll take it all away for the touchdown. And they had a tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense, keep yourself vulnerable in one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
So they go to the air on fourth down when they needed a big play, and boy, do they come through. And he tacks on the extra point. His own goal line. Across the 30. They'll bring him down at the 37. Golden Bears continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback is going to be looking for something better on this drive.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
And down he goes. The 47. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. And he's hit immediately.
He had a couple of freight trains at him, but when they blitzed, it created a hole in the coverage, and they took advantage of it.
Bring him down right around the 34. That will make it 7 inches. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
Brought down at the 18-yard line. So at the end of the third quarter, the Golden Bears lead 14-3. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
That's not what you hope for from your running game. You're looking for some solid north and south progress. You never want to give the defense a play like that to build their confidence.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. Tackles him hard at the 13. Here's the eighth play of the series. And that one's incomplete. Second and 10. Ball on the 13. And they make the stop at the 18.
Really good job by the big guys up front to use their size and speed and get the runner in the backfield.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Tackled at the 10.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Now he tries to buy some time. Tackle made at the 9. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Runs it right. Nice pickup.
Gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
They line up at the 14. Second down. Just under 3 to go in regulation. He has some room, and he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's a gain of 4 along the way. That'll bring them 3rd and 2.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut. And they convert the first down on that run.
Yeah, the key to that play is a good blocking up front by the Hog Mollies.
From their own 24-yard line, it's first down. On the ground, he won't get back to the line.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
Nice run, and he's brought down. The Sun Devils use their second timeout. And once again, they'll come try to convert on third down. Looks for his running back, incomplete.
That was the intention to see the running back. That makes it 4th and 8.
Allen is waiting for the snap. Gets to about the 44-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Just under 2 to go. Caught, open field. He's taken down right around the 28-yard line. Pressure, and he's going to be sacked for a loss.
That is a loss of 5 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 15.
The spike will stop the clock.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 18. He's looking for six. Touchdown! Late in the fourth quarter, and the big question is, in a game this close, who's going to crack first? So the kicker's going to stay on the sidelines. These guys will try for a two-point conversion. Play 57-yard drive, but they just get 6 points after failing to convert for two.
I think the big thing there, Brad, is that they were able to execute. When you can get big plays and great execution, obviously you can move the ball down the field.
So our score, 14-9, and down he goes at the 43.
So not a lot of time left, and they've got an opportunity right now, if they score, to put the nail in the coffin in this game. A little over a minute in the game. He fights forward to about the 43.
And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
The Sun Devils using their third and last timeout.
From the 43-yard line, second down. Tailback brought down for a loss. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed him.
And their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ballgame. And now the offense has got a chance to win it.
Fleming will be the return man.